Hello, everybody. Welcome back to High Functioning Gaming. Well, hang on. Don't I already have a necklace stack that's got a Terra type? Well, a Terra type that isn't rock. Yeah, I do. Okay. I think I already have a Happiny, so I don't need to catch a Chansey. Even if there were any around, which it doesn't look like there are. I swear, why does the game do this kind of crap? Whatever. Oh, Sableye. Not bad. Started to glide at too low an altitude. There. Male or female? Male. Still kind of used to the bag being the second option from the top. Seems like an odd problem. But is it slower? It is, okay. You know, I'm pretty sure in past generations, the Pokemon's eyes would close if they fell asleep. Hmm. Because you picked the wrong opponent, you now have to hand over your lunch money. So, what is the... looks like a Gabite. Must be a 1 in 8 chance. I was hoping I could have it remember Stomp. If only because it's got a whole bunch of power points. At least I think it does. Good boy. Dagnabbit! Forgot to use an ether too. Yeah, sure. That's not rare. Well, not that rare. Might as well use double kick again. He's got plenty of power points. Itself. Crap. All right. Brute force then. So strong, so wonderful. Derp. Yeah, it's a Gabite. Ah, man, that would be a pretty good addition, but I'm... got a sneaking suspicion that it's probably level, you know, 50, so... I'd have a hell of a time even weakening it. Let alone catching it. Man, that thing is slow! Tough, though. Coins from that. Yosh. Ah! You're supposed to drop down onto it from above. Better be one among you that can actually evolve. Ah, finally! Let's see. Only female snake can produce gas laden with pheromones. Males entranced by this gas will do whatever the females tell them. Some pretty strong perfume. Oops, wrong button. Oh, curl gunk. This might not do it. Yeah, for the try anyway. Fine. Okay. Huh. I kind of doubt that my Pokemon are up to snuff for taking on the gym. to check is to see what the level of the surrounding Pokemon is. Okay, I can handle that. Not a good idea. I just had a bit of an interesting thought. What if Saucebuck's different forms had access to different moves to kind of reflect the season that they their form is associated with? Like, winter form would have an ice type attack. Or two, maybe three. But then again, I suppose I'd bring up the question of what kind of attacks would the other three forms have? Man, that is one tough squirrel! Not quite as quick as I thought it would be, though. Maybe its nature trades speed for defense. Let's see, use it torches everything around it in an inferno of scarlet flames. May also leave those it burns with a those it hits with a burn. Pair may be seen rubbing their cheek pouches together in an effort to share stored electricity. Yeah, somehow I doubt you have an objective statement in regards to what Pokemon is the cutest. Yourself. Darn it! There we go. Gee, if you focused more on the battle and less on how cute your pommo was, maybe you wouldn't have to hand over your money. Dang it. I think there was a dragon type TM. Oops. I ain't gonna do a whole lot of damage. This might. Oh, you gotta be kidding me! At least I'm sure to defeat it this way. Yeah, where's the Pokemon League rep? Oh, finally! So I wonder if I'd manage to find a toadstool. I thought it was supposed to be kind of fast. Or is Varum just really fast? Yeah. Let's see, there, it looks like Tentacool. Toadstool is a completely different species. Its legs may be thin, but it can run at a speed of 30 miles per hour. I'm sorry, that just makes for a really funny mental image. Some guy running track, and then all of a sudden, get passed easily by a toadstool. No, Breloom. Oh wait, that's right, Terra type. Whatever it is, probably not fighting or grass. Fletchender. Maybe the rep is at this Pokemon Center. Yep, that's him right there. Huh. Why did I think I had defeated more than that? Suppose that'll be one of life's great mysteries. Seen some this way. Probably gonna need the XP anyway. Yep. Where are they? There we go. Now, goody, a premier ball. Yay! Mudsy would completely clobber the room. Unless it did that. And it uses sludge. took a steep fall. Huh. Didn't expect to see an ice type Pokemon so soon. Not that I'm complaining. I'm trying to catch the thing. Lives in frigid regions in pods of 5 or so individuals. Loves the materials found in snow and ice. Or minerals found in snow and ice. Except... cut it by nature, typically aren't minerals found in that. What the heck? There's another one right behind me like that. I don't think so. Cold places like this, my life gets a bit easier. Why? That did not go as planned, obviously. I had a hunch Thunderbird was faster. I guess nothing going on with them. Only my deliveries get easier, you know? Battling's as tough as always. Okay, but why does it get easier? Ah, that's why! Oh, there's an item down here anyway. Might have overdone it a bit there. Oh yeah, that's right. Alright. Hmm? Is that always there? Oh. Yeah, of course it was, because it's a sign, not an item. And there's the buzzer, so as always folks, do not stop being awesome and I'll catch you in the next video. But until then, take care.